Welcome back to CES 2020. I am still Matt Stephenson, and now for something completely different. I give you 650E. How do we even describe who you are, what you do, how awesome everything you get to play with is? I'm gonna let you have that one.
Okay, Matt. Well, I would describe myself as social media professional, okay? The king of the hill in social media. So what I do is I promote and just do talk a lot about sport bikes in general.
Sport bike journalist, only in short form fashion.
Yeah. So I love sport bikes. I mean, it shows in everything that I do. I love being around them. I love track days. I love, going out and meeting up with people that ride sport bikes. Just spreading the word that motorcycling is not dead. It's still a great sport, a great pastime, really something that the average person can do and enjoy.
Now, what brings you here, though, you have a very interesting relationship with Damon. You're not some hired gun that they just want, like, lounging on the new bike. You got a little different story as far as how you got involved with Damon Motorcycles.
Yeah. So I reached out to them. You know, I really love the product that they're going to be releasing here real soon.
But, Eve, what product is that?
The Damon Motorcycle, right there in the flesh. There it is. How could you not love this beautiful motorcycle? 200 horsepower, 200 mile range. It's unbelievable. And 200 all over the place.
But that was the thing, is a guy who your job is to do this stuff. You love these things, you go find the ones you want. This wasn't them reaching out and saying, hey man, do you mind doing some posts and helping us out on this stuff? You found this bike and said, hey, I would like to talk to you and see what we could do.
Yeah, man, I love it. I mean, I found it on the internet, saw some posts they had done, and the specs that they were describing, the way that it looks, the innovative features that it's gonna have as far as safety, really made me reach out to them and say, I want to be a part of this. I kind of forced myself on them because I loved it so much.
Now, as far as what they're doing that's different, without naming any names about any of the other electric bikes in the marketplace, okay. 200 miles an hour, 200 mile range is a big deal. I know it sounds like we're just blowing up the specs, but it really is different. They're kind of ahead of the curve on this stuff.
It is different. I rode another unnamed motorcycle, Matt, that we're not going to mention.
I'm sure they were very nice.
Yes, it was nice, but it had about a top speed, and I tested it out at about 140 mile an hour. And
that's
in this day and age, that's not enough. You know, I mean,
it's not a super bike.
Yeah.
It's a fine bike, but
it's not super, you know. So, you know, what people really want in this day and age, Matt, they want speed, they want range. They want comfort, and this bike delivers all of that. And then you got a niche of people like me that love technology. And this bike packs the technology that I crave and love.
So what did you find when you're looking at that stuff? You mentioned safety, and that's a thing we've talked about a little bit on some of the stuff we've done with Damon. But what is it that is different when you get on this bike compared to even gas-powered bikes or other, doesn't have to be electric. Like, why is it safer?
The number one thing when I tested this bike out was the haptic feedback. The fact that if there's an imminent issue coming up, the handlebars are going to vibrate to let you know. If you turn your back to look at some traffic behind you and there's a car coming out in cross traffic that could possibly strike you, the handlebars are going to vibrate to let you know.
So this is straight up PlayStation DualShock controller influence. I say that kind of half kiddingly. We grew up in the video game age. Are designers, developers, are they influenced by like MotoGP and Need for Speed and stuff like that? I mean, do you think that you start playing those when you're 7 or 8, now you're designing these when you're 12 or 13, I'm sure some of these guys, but is that legit or am I just pushing my fantasies on this stuff?
You're exactly right, Matt. I think the designers of these bikes, they come from the age of high tech. You know, they come from the age of we need something that's innovative, we need something that's going to make the rider safe, and they actually finally, after all these decades, put it into a motorcycle. It's absolutely amazing. And it's exactly why I get so excited about talking about this bike.
Look at his face. You think that's not excited?
Yeah.
And you ride, though. I mean, that's the other thing. You're not just a guy that's like putting these in a wind tunnel and studying the aerodynamic flow.
No,
like you're out
no,
there.
No. I ride on the street and the track. I've got a variety of motorcycles from a Kawasaki Ninja H2 to a Ducati V4R, Yamaha R1M, Honda CBR 1000, RRR, SP, you know, everything, you name it. And this bike, I'm fondly looking forward to adding to my collection. And the only problem I have with this bike, Matt, is I want it right now. Right now!
And that's the easy cue up for when is the bike going to be available?
Yeah, mid-2021. So basically, a year and 6 months or so from now, we'll be able to actually ride these bikes. And I'll make a vlog about it. I'll send you the link to it. You'll watch it. Hopefully, you'll give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. and everybody will be happy.
Well, and you can't throw that out there without all of the shameless plugs. So for those of you in the world who do not know 650 EEB yet, please let them know where to find you.
Yeah, 650 EEB, 650 IB. That's my handle for YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook.
And I cannot let it go without saying that one of the things that keep this stuff safe is the BlackBerry QNX technology that is in there. But that's another story for another time. Just make sure you check that out at BlackBerry.com, also at BlackBerry on the Twitter. I am Matt Stephenson. I am at PacMatt73. I do not ride motorcycles, but I am going to check this stuff out. Maybe you get me on one of these things, teach me how to ride.
I want you to ride a motorcycle.
All right, fair.
I'll supply you with the bike and the gear. You just come and ride.
That sounds like a video series you're going to want to see.